An engaging day indeed, and that is what we're looking forward to. And to present the opening remarks, may I have the pleasure of inviting on stage Mr. Abhishek Somani, Joint Managing Director, Somani Ceramics, with over 18 years of experience in the ceramic industry and the international marketing. He has bagged himself many an awards, to name a few. He was announced and awarded to the Indian Power Brand Award along with Asia's Most Promising Brand of the Year in the Ceramics title category. Along with this, the Power Brand Hall of Fame Corporate Leader in the Ceramic Industry for 2011-2012. Let's put our hands together for a man who truly enjoys taking his step further and the country, Mr. Somani.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I acknowledge the presence of all the good morning. I'm still in the evening. acknowledge the presence of all the eminent personalities, important personalities amongst us. As Mr. Lamba said, that it's been a great journey since last year, where we started off with this program, where we developed it into a knowledge series rather than just another award function. And trying to create exactly what he says, where bring in all the stakeholders, which is the government, the architects, the interiors, and also the builders, and trying to make a better India, make a name for India. I mean, how many we had Nehruji call on Le Corbusier, and he was asked with a very clear mandate to make Chandigarh, and more importantly, there were very free hands given to him to design what he designed. In fact, we're very proud that that's probably the only city which has been created after independence, so to say. I truly believe that this day and age, 60 years from then, more than 60 years from then, we now have urban planners amongst us which can create what he created at that time. How many of us would acknowledge that the cities which were planned by the British pre-independence and Chandigarh post-independence, how many cities have we created with that kind of urban planning, that kind of design, be it the Gurgaons, be it the suburbs of Bombay or suburbs of Chennai, whatever so it might be. There has been very little planning, very little urban planning, and I think the biggest reason for that is that all the stakeholders haven't been asked and haven't been questioned, haven't been brought together on a certain platform. All the planning has been done with their own internal interests. The builders had their own internal interests, the policymakers have their own internal interests, but nobody has gotten together to really try and create a city which could replicate what the British created or what Le Corbusier created. With Chandigarh. In fact, even Chandigarh has completely gone haywire with the other three cities which has come around Chandigarh. So I think this knowledge series was to bring a little more focus onto this, where hopefully the new government, while it's talking of the 100 smart cities, which is the current smart cities becoming smarter, or rather current cities becoming smarter, we would, with the Delhi-Mumbai corridor and the various other corridors which they are planning and are already taking, getting off ground, I think there would be a lot of small satellite and big cities coming up around the country. We have an example of that where Mr. Modi, while he was Chief Minister in Gujarat, announced of Dholera, which is a new city which he wants to build. I think it's 10 years from today, but there is a clear direction which he has given there, and I'm sure the way he works, there would be a reasonable amount of urban planning before that city is made. So such cities, I'm sure, would mushroom across India, and it's for us to, you know, come together very earnestly, sincerely, which is the government, the industry, the builders, and the architects, come together and plan certain cities which become iconic, and we're very proud, and India is proud of these cities. We've seen with the Delhi Metro being right under our nose here, when you give a world-class infrastructure to the same people whom we keep accusing of, you know, spitting on each and every wall and urinating on each and every wall, the same citizens, when they're given a world-class infrastructure, if any of you have traveled with the Delhi Metro, is probably one of the cleanest and better metros worldwide. So what I'm trying to say is, if you give the citizens a good infrastructure, a top-class infrastructure, they're proud of it. And the minute you're proud of it, you would then maintain it. So that's something which the government hasn't given. We've been, as taxpayers, cheated of that. So therefore, it is up to us, with this new government, with a completely new leaf, hopefully in India is turning, I am very positive. We should be able to come together and turn a new leaf ourselves and be proud of what we manufacture, be it what we do, which is tiles, be it what you do, which is your drawings, your architecture, be it the builders, what they produce. We had an example yesterday where Mr. Khera was telling us how a builder completely cheated him in Delhi. So these are things which need to change. And this endeavor of this ET Edge summit, which we are partnering with, should be able to bring certain clarity. And what better media than ET and Times of India to carry this forward, this message forward, as to whatever we discuss in this day, also the other days we've had in the satellite cities, the smaller cities across the west last year and across north this year. So whatever we discussed, please carry it forward to the policy makers so that we definitely get proud of what we're doing and get some more traction off ground. Thank you very much. I hope you enjoy the rest of the day.